the Philly and Ohio card.
Yeah, but when a good card is a good card, it could be on the moon, it could be on Mars. People are going to tune in.
Yeah, it's going to be a good card, though.
Sure. Adrian, listen, there's very few fighters that I've seen personally that could walk down the street and create a mob after them.
Yeah.
Nate Diaz, Canelo, Floyd, Tank, yourself, and a couple more. It doesn't happen very often. Mm. Why is that? What is it about you guys that makes it different than other people?
We just stick out like a sore thumb, man. You know, sometimes and something you got to make. You got to make your mark, and you just got to be different. You got to be yourself, and people will gravitate towards you. And I think that's what I did. You know, I never tried to be something that I'm not. I never tried to be, you know, don't get me wrong. I've took some things from other people and I put it into my own way, but I always was just being myself, and people gravitated towards it. And that's why motherfuckers love me.
You're an entertainer. You make them smile. You light up the room.
Yeah, when I come in the room, yeah, everybody come around me and smile, man. You know, I ain't somebody that's gonna come around and keep you angry. I some things I might say might rub off on some people the wrong way, but it comes from a good place, man.
But I'm gonna say something. Everybody here in this car knows what I'm about to say, but maybe people at home have no idea. I'm driving with you in Cincinnati at 2 a.m. You stop at a stoplight, not for the video, not for cameras, and you give homeless money. Kobe Bryant used to do that too, by the way. Other people that we know in boxing, hey, do a selfie, shoot a vid, make sure you record me. Why? So, A, you're a good person because you give back when no one's looking. And B, why do stuff like that?
I mean, you know, I do something that I feel on spot. If I feel it in my heart on the spot, I'm going to do it. If I just don't feel it, I'm not going to do it. You know, that's just me. If I see somebody in need and I got it, and I got it to give, you can have it. You can have my shirt off my back. If I got it to give, if I'm going to an event, maybe not. But on a regular day, and I see you need a shirt, I give you a shirt off my back, man. I ain't tripping, because I know I can go out here and get another shirt. You know what I mean?
You're in a grocery store, you pay for the entire line in front of you, groceries for families.
Yeah.
But people don't know that about you.
Yeah, I love doing that type of shit, man. Just putting smiles on people's face. Because you just never know what people are going through in their life. And then for me to come through and just bless people like that, you know that? I like seeing smiles on other faces.
No, definitely. Your life's been a crazy roller coaster from the highs to the lows. Now, hopefully back high and stay high, like stay up.
Yeah, that's what we're pushing for.
And tell me about being with Coach Kevin for this camp.
We know what we, not only we knew what we needed, we knew what we wanted. And, you know, me and him, we like night and day, but our relationship is close, and we know each other. And he ain't here to play. So,
Kevin, you're not playing?
Hell no, I ain't playing. He all business. Well, once my hand get raised, then we could do some smiling and smirking. But until then,
all business.
That's it.
Kevin, how talented is Adrian Broner?
Basically, he can do anything he want to do in there, man. He's got the skill and the talent to do whatever, you know.
He's a very hard worker.
Hell yeah.
Can you keep a straight face in camp, or are you always smiling?
Who you talking to?
You.
Who you asking me? Am I always smiling? I know you didn't just ask me that question.
That's
you
a smile.
Really just asked me that?
Hey, Ellie. You might have to catch an Uber back.
When shit go right, I'm smiling. Yeah. No, yeah. We, this been a great camp. Really.
No, it's a blessing. Yeah, it's a good situation.
He's got his mind made up. And you know the saying goes, right? Ain't nothing like a made up mind. He got his mind made up. Gonna do his thing in Atlanta.
What's the motivation now, Adrian? What pushes you? It's not easy to wake up at 6 a.m.
You know the biggest thing that pushed me, man? The doubt. The rumors, the doubt, the with the position I was in and the things I heard that I'm not gonna repeat, but and from the people it came from, that's what hurt me the most. And that's what made me like, all right, now it's time to show not only them, but the whole world, because these motherfuckers really thought that I was just gonna sit and rot and fuck off and be another story that somebody that was great or that was one of the best in the world and that fell off and all he do is drink, you know, he's broke and he have nothing. You know, they thought that I was gonna be one of them stories, but we gonna change the narrative.
And flip the script?
Flip the script and finish this shit right.
There's not, listen, they always say you're haters, or you're, not that people are haters, but you're motivators. Now you're energized. But what did you post the other day on Instagram? You said there's you smiling when it's hard because you know you're gonna be back on top.
Yeah, I smile through this shit. I put a smile on through the toughest time in my life because I know I got what it takes to bottle everything up, put my head down, put my mind on something, and get it done.
Do you find all the stuff you share every day on Instagram yourself, or do people send you stuff and then you post?
Nah, I think of a lot of it, and some stuff I see and I repost it, but
some stuff is really deep and philosophical, and some stuff is really funny.
Yeah. A lot of stuff they just be my thoughts. I jot it down and I put it up. See, a lot of people say, man, you should be on Twitter more because of the way I post on Instagram.
Yeah.
I'm just not into the Twitter thing, even though they say it's big. It's gotten bigger.
Elon Musk is announcing. Yeah, Elon Musk, if you're watching this and you want to sponsor Adrian Broner's fight February 25th, you can wear a Twitter patch on his trunks.
Sure can. Let's go, everything. Elon. I like Elon Musk, man. He got a...
He can sponsor you with the Tesla.
Hell yeah. Sure can. Elon Musk, hit me up. What's up? Let's do some work. I can wear a Twitter patch or... I wear Elon Musk patch.
No, shit. You're very financially savvy. He bought Twitter for $44 billion. What do you think?
I think it was a great investment. I think he got a plan. I don't think he's just buying it for just to buy it. I think he got a plan to do something. I want to see what it is. I want to see what to do with it.
What would you invest in with $44 billion? If you, let's say $40
billion. Man, listen. I don't even know the heights of that type of money. You know, but I know with the money that I get now, I have to invest. I will invest. And, you know, I'll do what I got to do to make sure my kids is good and that I'm good after my career. But, you know, that's some type of money that I don't know what I'll do with it because I never touched that type of money before. So, you know, all I can do is dream about that shit.
Now, I noticed you're wearing new gear. It's out there, AB. Tell me about that, the shirt.
Yeah.
Where do people buy it if they want to purchase?
Yeah, on the website, About Billions website. And, we got it in different colors, too.
About Billions.
Yes, sir.
Last time I was at one of your fights in Cincinnati, it was like a nightclub. It was a nightclub with boxing. This is going to be the same in Atlanta?
Yeah, they are having some fights out there the week of the fight. Yeah, that'd be big, man. That'd be funny. I'm not going to attend, though. But
yeah.
It's going to be some good fights. Some girls.
You're focused on Hank Lundy.
Hell yeah.
What do you tell him if he's watching, by the way? Because he's watching.
Man. I ain't talking to no goddamn Hank. I ain't got no reason to talk to Hank. He know what he know what's at stake. He know what he in for. And you know I ain't playing, man. I ain't about to play with that nigga.
Hammer told me 4 or 5 rounds. He said 4, 5, or 6.
I love an early fight. That means I can get out the ring and get my check faster.
So, like Wilder says, you don't get paid for overtime.
Yeah, you don't get paid for overtime. I ain't trying to throw no extra punches.
then you have a list of who's coming yet? Like, people hit you up, a lot of famous people, they want to come?
Yeah, a lot of. It's gonna be star studded for sure. It's gonna be a lot of. It's gonna be a lot of people there. You know, Atlanta like Black Hollywood, man. It's gonna be a lot of people there. It's gonna be a hell of an event. You don't want to miss this one.
By the way, Kevin, how did you get into boxing?
Man, I started boxing when I was 10 years old.
Did you fight?
Yeah. I fought on the Army team, too, when I went in the Army.
And then you started coaching?
Yeah, when I got out the Army, I went to the police academy. And when I was on the police department, I was looking for ways to help the youth and try to deal with the crime on the front end as opposed to waiting till these young people do something wrong and try to deal, and then you got to deal with it on the back end. And the only option they got is to get locked up. So I was trying to do something positive on the front end. And I was just, you know, thinking about what kept me out of trouble as a young person. And I was always playing football and boxing. I went from football season to boxing, trying to put on weight for football season every year. Then got to take it all off to get ready for the Golden Gloves every year. So, you know.
Okay.
So when I was on the police department, I found a old police building. The city gave it to me, and I built the gym and started the PAL in St. Louis. And the rest is history.
Amazing. Who's the best fighter you've ever seen fight?
Pernell Whitaker.
He's a bad motherfucker.
He was amazing. Who's your favorite you ever saw live? Kevin,
That was my era.
Floyd. Kevin, what's the best way to get out of it? If I get pulled over, what's the best way to get out of the ticket?
Well, if you was in St. Louis, just tell them you with me. But you down here in Florida, shit.
What's up, man?
I don't know what to tell you, but.
Just all right, don't mind, got the ticket.
What's Mike did? Miss Denise, I just wrote below.
Are you ever in touch with Manny Pacquiao?
Miss Denise.
Huh?
Are you in touch with Manny?
Yeah.
Every time I see him, I talk to him.
He's a good dude.
Yeah, every time I see him, I talk to him.
Is Manny Pacquiao invited to Atlanta, February 25th?
Of course.
Ringside. By Adrian Broner, Hammer, and Hank Lundy. If Manny wants to walk you out, would that be okay?
Saying, pray for him, but he ain't been answering or texting back. I just called him.
Huh?
If Pacquiao wanted to walk you out?
Mike.
Of course. Hell yeah, he can walk me out, man. That's fine. I love Pacquiao.
He's a legend.
Like that, man. He a legend.
What's up with him, though? He good? Because he normally tell me everything. I ain't even talking.
You haven't been to the Philippines yet, right?
Nah.
I think it's time to set up a visit.
Yeah, I'd love to go out there. But I ain't going out there without Pacquiao.
No. It's Manny. He ran for president this year, came up short, but he's a senator, he's a congressman. Mm-hmm.
Is he all right?
I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting. But ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Ellie Seckback, reporting.